गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज क्लास फिफ्थ चैप्टर सेकंड, इनपुट आउटपुट एंड सेकेंडरी स्टोरेज डिवाइसेस। स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव टू डिस्कस अबाउट इनपुट डिवाइसेस, आउटपुट डिवाइसेस एंड सेकेंडरी स्टोरेज डिवाइसेस। आर यू रेडी? या बट स्टूडेंट्स, बिफोर अंडरस्टैंडिंग द इनपुट आउटपुट एंड सेकेंडरी स्टोरेज डिवाइस, वी हैव टू डिस्कस हाउ ये कंप्यूटर वर्क, व्हाट इज कंप्यूटर, definition of the computer. On these topics we will discuss, then we will discuss about the input, output and secondary storage devices. So are you ready? Okay, students, continue. First we have to understand what is computer. If you are discussing about the computer, then we have to know about the computer. So this is also a machine, electronic machine. Listen. Computer is a machine or device that performs processes, calculations and operations based on instructions provided by a software or hardware program. It has the ability to accept data input, process it and then produce output. Students, here is the three things. One is the input, second is the process and third one is the output. So input always given by us. These are given with the help of input devices. After giving the input, computer process on the input, and after complete the processing, computer produce output to the user. So here is the three things: input, process and output. Input is given by the input devices, process is done by the processing device, and output is produced by the output devices. Here is the simple definition of available also for the computer. Computer is an electronic device which takes input from user and produce output to the user. Students, one more and important thing is you have to see here. Charles Babbage is known as the father of computer. Charles Babbage, he developed the two important machines. One was the analytical engine and second one is difference engine. Your modern computer follow the working principle from difference engine. That's why Charles Babbage is known as the father of computer. How does a computer work? हमारे mind में बार बार एक question आता होगा कि computer work कैसे करता है. तो look it here. As you know, the computer accepts data from user in the form of numbers, text or pictures. It is processed or manipulated by the computer to give a meaningful result. The processed data can be stored in the memory of computer. This is the working principle of the computer: input, process, output. This is also known as IPO cycle. This is the working principle: I for input, P for processing and O for output. Here is some fact also: data. What is data? Data, a collection of facts and figures, is said to be the data. The data is fed into a computer. Input, data or instructions given to the computer known as input. Output, after processing, computer produced result to the user known as output. Next, hardware. As you know, students, there is the major two parts of your computer system. One is the hardware and second is software. So first we have to discuss about the hardware. You know, students, all the physical parts of your computer system which you can see and touch known as hardware. Front of you there is a keyboard, monitor, printer, mouse. All physical parts are available there. These parts are known as hardware. Definition is, all the physical parts or components of computer system which we can see and touch known as hardware. For example, keyboard, mouse, monitor, etc. One picture is also given here. That is also, these are also the example of hardware. Look at here, his speaker is here, monitor is here, keyboard is here, power supply unit is also, DVD-ROM, motherboard, CPU, CPU fan, RAM, VGA card, sound card, hard disk and DVD writer. So these all are the hardwares. Here is the categories of hardware is also available here. Hardware is mainly categorized into four parts. One is the input device, second is the processing device, third one is output device, and fourth one is the storage device. And in this chapter, we will discuss about input device, output devices, and storage device. Student, storage devices. First is the input device. Input device is a piece of computer hardware equipment used to provide data and control signals to an information processing system, such as a computer or information appliance. Examples of input devices include keyboard, mouse, scanners, digital cameras, joysticks, and microphones. In the simple words, you can say the device which is used to give data or instructions to the computer, known as input device. These devices help to feed data into the computer system, or you can say input data into the computer system. And your computer depends on your instructions, depends on your inputs, and these inputs given with the help of input device. Here is the some more examples also for input devices here. This is the touch screen, this is camera, this is scanner, keyboard, mouse, this is also joystick. This is help to play games. One is the trackball is also here, but nowadays we are not using trackball. This is webcam, this is the microphone. Here we will discuss in detail about some input devices. First one is the keyboard. It is the most widely used input device. It is used to enter data which are sent to the CPU for further processing. Students, you know which type of data we can give to the computer with the help of keyboard. Mainly we have to use keyboard to enter text and numbers into the computer system. Okay. Next, scanner. It is an input device used for transferring the images of the text or photographs from the source or the storage devices for further processing. Student, scanners are used to insert directly your ready-made pictures into the computer system. You can also use camera, but scanner have a different functions also. It is also used to convert your images into PDF form. After that, mouse. A mouse is popularly known as pointing device, which is connected to the CPU. It has a roller at the bottom on which it can roll. Optical mouse replaces roller with the sensor to sense position on the screen. After that, barcode reader. A barcode reader emits laser beam which falls on the cords. The computer understands these codes and tells the price and other details of the product. Students, nearby you have something on which you have to see some lines on the product, some thick lines, some thin lines, and there is some numbers is also mentioned below there. So those codes are known as barcodes. That barcode is read with the help of a device that is known as barcode reader. Sometimes if you have on your shop, so sometimes one people is just put your product and use a device to print your bill. That device is known as barcode reader. Joystick. Joystick is an input device widely used for playing games on the computer. After that, output device. An output device is any device used to send data from a computer to another device or user. Most computer data output that is meant for humans is in the form of audio or video. Thus, most output devices used by humans are in these categories. For example, examples include monitor, video. Students, remember one important thing: video. This is the other name of your monitor, which is in this expanded form is visual display unit. V for visual, D for display, U for unit. This is the other name of your monitor. Projectors, speakers, headphones, and printers are also the example of output devices. In the simple words, you can say the device which is used to produce result to the user known as output device. Examples are the same, your monitors, projectors, speakers, headphones, and printers. Here is the images is also given of your projector, speaker, monitor, printer. This is the headphone. But students, remember, one is also this part is here. Na? You know what is this? This part is known as microphone. But students, microphone is input device. But in this side and this side, here is the two speakers also. Speakers are output device, but microphone is input device. Detailed discuss about the some output devices. Monitor, students, you have seen in your computer lab, maybe at your home also, it looks like your television, your TV screen. Just like your TV, it also shows what we are doing on the computer. All the works we are doing on our computer, which is shown on your monitor. Monitor is an output device also known as visual display unit. The second name of your monitor is VDU, visual display unit. It is used to show on the screen what we are doing on the computer. After that, printer. Students, if you want to take hard copy of our output, that work is done with the help of printer. Here is the some different types of printers are also here. One is the dot matrix printer, second one is inkjet printer, third one is the laser printer. Dot matrix printer, it is one of the most popular, low cost. Here is there some mistake, it is low cost impact printer. It leaves the impression of characters in the form of dots. Students, this is the one important part is here, impact printer. Students, printers are in the two, mainly student printers are the two types. One is the impact and second is the non-impact. Impact printer, dot matrix printer is in the category of impact printers. Inkjet printer, it is non-impact printer. It prints using spraying on the paper. Laser printer, these printers have a very high speed of printing and with a good quality in printing. After that, liquid crystal projectors. Students, you have seen the projectors in your classroom also that are used by your teachers to teach you. After that, storage device. Students, storage devices are used to store your information in the form of different file formats. Maybe your MS Word file, maybe your Excel file, maybe your PowerPoint presentation, maybe your MS Paint drawing, maybe your audio file, maybe your video file. These are the different formats of your files. These can be stored in the storage devices. A storage device is used for storing, porting, and extracting data files and objects. It can hold and store information both temporarily and permanently. It can be internal or external to a computer. Students, here is the two important. One is the temporarily or permanently, and second is internal or external. First, we have to understand the temporarily and permanently. Students, in the computer, we can store data for the temporary or for the permanent. Temporary means for a short time. Means your data will tab tak rahega if electricity is there. If there is no electricity, your data will be lost. This type of data stored in the form of temporarily. Permanently, we can store until we delete it. जब तक हम डिलीट नहीं करेंगे तब तक हमारा डाटा कंप्यूटर में रहेगा. दैट फॉर्मेट इज फॉर्म इज नॉन एज परमानेंटली फॉर्म. ओके, आफ्टर दैट इंटरनल एंड एक्सटर्नल. students, storage devices are internal, or you can say internal is also known as fixed storage device, and external storage device also known as portable storage device. I hope you all have seen the pen drives. What are these? Pen drives are the external storage device, or you can say portable storage device. But the hard disk is also there, but that is fixed inside the computer. So that is known as internal, or you can also say fixed storage device. In the simple words, a storage device is used to store information temporarily or permanently. It can be fixed or portable, known as storage device. After that, here is the types of computer memory. This is also known as the types of, you can say, storage device. Mainly your computer memory is the two types, primary memory and secondary memory. But here we are discussing about the secondary memory, not about the primary memory. Secondary memory types are the storage as hard disk, your CDs, DVDs, pen drives and floppies. I'm also showing the images of them. Hard disk, RAM, ROM. These two are the internal storage devices. Okay? Or you can say these are also known as primary storage devices. After that, CD and DVDs. These are looks like the same. Floppy disk, memory card. This is used in your mobile phones also. Pen drive. I hope you have all seen about these pen drives. And this is the magnetic tape. Students, this is the floppy disk. Na? Nowadays we are not using floppy disk, but before sometimes also used this storage device. This is a low storage device. It can store up to 1.44 MB data. How much data it can store? It will store 1.44 MB, means low storage devices. Types we have already done. After that, exercise. First is the fill in the blanks. The full form of CPU is central processing unit. A keyboard is an input device. Blank is connected to your computer system to give the output in readable form. That is known as printer. Storage device. Storage devices are used to store the data or instructions, documents, data for future use. The storage capacity of 3.5 disk is 1.44 MB. Exercises. The full form of CPU is central processing unit. A keyboard is an input device. Printer is connected to a computer system to give the output in readable form. Storage devices are used to store the instruction document data for future use. The storage capacity of 3.5 floppy disk is 1.44 MB. Exercise. Classify the following in terms of input-output secondary storage device. Joystick, input device. Mouse, input device. Barcode reader, input device. Scanner, input device. Dot matrix printer, output device. Laser printer, output device. Keyboard, input device. Inkjet printer, output device. Floppy disk, storage device. And speaker is output device. Short answer question. Define the following, giving two examples of each. Input device. The device which is used to give data or instructions to the computer known as input device. For example, keyboard, mouse. Output device. The device which is used to produce result to the user known as output device. Examples include monitor, projector, speaker, headphone and printer. Secondary storage device. A storage device It's used to storing, porting and accessing data files and objects. It can hold and store information both temporarily and permanently, and can be internal or external to a computer. For example, hard disk, floppy disk. Long. Answers. First is keyboard. It is most widely used input device. It is used to enter data which are sent to the CPU for further processing. It used to enter text numbers into the computer system. Mouse. A mouse is popularly known as pointing device which is connected to the CPU. It has a roller at the bottom on which it can roll. Optical mouse replaces roller with sensor to send position on the screen. Barcode reader. A barcode reader emits laser beam which falls on codes. The computer understands these codes and tells the price and other details of the product. Joystick. It is an input device widely used for playing games on the computer. Monitor. Monitor is an output device, also known as visual display unit. It is used to show on the screen what we are doing on the computer. Dot matrix printer. It is one of the most popularly low-cost impact printer. It leaves the impression of characters in form of dots. Inkjet printer. It is non-impact printer. It prints using spraying on the papers. Laser printer. These printers have a very high speed of printing and with a quality in printing. Optical disc. A plastic coated optical disc and electronic data storage medium can be used to write and read using a low power laser beam. Thanks. Thank you very much, students.